How do you declutter books? It can be hard to try to figure out what books to keep and which ones to let go, especially if you are a bookworm like I am. In today's video, I want to share with you the method that I use when decluttering books and how I maintain a minimalist book collection, as well as a couple of questions to ask yourself while you are decluttering your books. This video is part of a collaboration with Dawn the Minimal Mom and several other YouTubers who are also sharing how they declutter their books as well as their board games and magazines, so make sure you check out the playlist. I'll link it down below. Also, if you're new here, welcome. I make videos all about minimalism and simple living, so if that sounds interesting to you, make sure you hit that subscribe button below. Once upon a time, I had a large book collection, which I don't have pictures of or anything. This was many, many years ago, way before I even knew what decluttering or minimalism was. But ever since then, I have implemented the container method, which I still use to this day. So what is the container method? Basically, it's exactly what it sounds like. It is a container or a space that you choose to have your books filled in with. This can be a bookcase, a shelf, the closet, wherever you keep your books. You need to figure out the designated space where all your books are going to live. So what I use right now is actually my entertainment center, where it's under my TV. I keep all of my books, which are not that many, but I do keep them all in there. And that is a space where only my books go. What I love about the container method is that you are setting yourself a limitation for how much that space can actually hold the books. Once I notice that that space is getting full, then I know it's time to declutter or see what I can get rid of that I do not want or read anymore. So when I'm decluttering, I ask myself two questions. Will I ever read it again? And would I recommend it? Asking myself these two questions and answering them honestly helps me maintain a minimalist book collection. Because I live in such a small space and have a small space to work with, it also really helps me to just be more mindful of the books that I want to keep. Now, I am a big bookworm. I love to read, so sometimes letting books go, it can be hard, but not because it's an emotional attachment. It's just because I love to have physical books around. Another way that I've been able to maintain my book collection very minimal, besides the container method, is using a little free resource called the library. Because I'm such a bookworm, I've used the library for many, many, many years, and I absolutely love going there and checking out books. If you have not taken advantage of your local library yet, what are you waiting for? You have to go and check it out. Go onto the website and search for any book that you're looking for, and I can almost guarantee that you will find what you're looking for at your local library. I love using the library not only because it is a free resource, but also because I can read something and if I don't like it, I can just return it right back. There are a couple of times where I will read something that I check out from the library and I absolutely love, and if it's something that I do love, I will try to find it secondhand or used and buy it from there to add to my book collection. This is very rare, but every once in a while it does happen, so I love that I'm able to do this. I can already read it through the library and see if I actually love it. That way I can bring it into my home secondhand if I can find it and add it to my book collection that way. All right, so now that I've shared with you a couple of tips and the methods that I use, I will now show you my book collection and do a little bit of decluttering. So this is where I keep my books in the entertainment center. I only have them in this side, and I like that it's kind of hidden away so it's not out in the open. At the top we just have some DVDs, and then here are all of my books. Right now there is no method, it's just kind of shoved in there, but I find the space is not too big, or else I think I would have more books in here, but the space is perfect for the current books that I have, which is not that many as you can see. So let's go ahead and pull all of them out. I know there's a few that I want to declutter. I for sure want to keep all of those. These are all of my hardcover books. This one I know I want to declutter because I got this in the beginning of the quarantine and I was looking for some books to read, so I picked this up from Target and I read it once through and it was a really good book, but I don't think I'll be reading it again, so I'm going to donate this. This is a book that I've had, I think, since high school, and I just never read it. So I feel like a lot of us have those types of books where we want to read or we've had for a long time, but we just never read them for whatever reason, right? And it's not even that big of a book, so I don't know why, I just have never read this. So I am going to make it a point to read it finally. I'm actually almost done with the current book that I'm reading, so definitely going to start reading this. It's been way too long that I've had this and held on to it for whatever reason. I will definitely have to donate this, because if I've had this book for this long and I haven't read it yet, I don't think I will read it ever again. So after this one time that I read it, I will donate this. So as you guys can see, I have a lot of self-help personal development books, which are my favorite to read. And here's another one that I've had for a while. I think this was one of my first self-improvement books, so I liked it. Again, just not something that I'm going to read again, so we're going to put this in the declutter pile. So here is what I'm keeping, and these as well. Normally what I would do, I would stand these up, but these books are too big, so they will not fit because of the shelf up here. And so that's why I have most of these laying down like that. So I'm gonna push those back there. So off camera, I kind of just move stuff around, try to see what I like the best. So I think I'm gonna stick with this. So in the very back, I have all my hardcover books. These ones could fit up here in this little space right there, so I put those there. And then the other ones, I'm just gonna lay down like this. If you guys can think of any other better way to organize this, please let me know, because I don't know if I'm 100% satisfied with it, but it is what it is. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so yet, and check out the playlist linked down below, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!